to New York Post Studio in Midtown Manhattan. I'm Mark Hale. We're going to be talking Giants Cowboys as they get set for their rematch this Sunday afternoon at 4 o'clock in Dallas. I want to bring in our lead sports columnist Mike Vaccaro to do our triple play, three questions for Vac, all on Giants Cowboys. Vac, in week one, these two teams played. Dallas took a 24-17 win at MetLife Stadium. And Tony Romo kind of tore these guys up. He had three touchdown passes, two to Kevin Ogletree, one to Miles Austin. The Giants secondary was a little banged up in that game, Vac, but when we go into this rematch this Sunday, how important is it for the Giants secondary kind of going against Romo and these receivers, Austin, Dez Bryant, Jason Witten? Can they shut these guys down in the rematch?
I think they can, Mark. I mean, for one thing, I think that we saw them at their very worst in week one. I do think they've improved some since then. I thought the secondary is a whole lot of wonderful game against the Niners, and I think the Niners are certainly more of a threat, if you look at it on paper, than the Cowboys are. I don't care where the Cowboys are playing, I know they're playing at home. But I think the Giants look at this not only as a revenge game, but an opportunity to really seize control in the division. You lose this game, you kind of let the Cowboys into thinking they can maybe sneak to the NFC East, especially since they'll have two wins against the Giants. They're just playing better right now, and I think that'll come through on Sunday, especially going against Romo, who I don't think anybody, whether you're a Giants fan, a Cowboys fan, or a neutral fan, has a lot of faith in.
All right, move on to the second question here, Vac. Eli Manning coming off a game-winning touchdown pass against Washington this past Sunday afternoon. Let me ask you a question, Vac. We're seven games into the Giants season. At this point in the year, can we talk about Eli Manning as the NFL MVP? He's first in the NFL in passing yardage. He's second in that ESPN quarterback ranking. Or is this a little bit overkill? Are there still players and maybe even quarterbacks that are ahead of Eli right now?
Well, I think you can definitely have a conversation about it. Why not? Although I will warn you that 70 games into the baseball season, we all thought David Wright might be the MVP of the National League. So certainly, you know, when you have more than 50% of the season, a lot of stuff can happen. You would think that that Aaron Rodgers is only going to get better. You would think that Drew Brees is probably going to get better. Yep. Just to name two guys who play the same position. That said, right now, I mean, look, if you're voting based upon what the award says it is, it's hard to imagine anybody who's more valuable to his team than Eli Manning is right now. Even though, you know, we're not talking about the most perfect quarterback or the most, the most beautiful looking quarterback rating, and you know, Eli's never going to win that award, but when you're talking about value and you just see what, it's uncanny, really. I was in the press box in New England when he got the ball back, and it's really kind of funny to watch how people react to the Giants getting the ball back with a minute and a half to go. It's not just, you know, will Eli lead them back? It's how much time will it take Eli to lead them back? And I think that when you have that kind of mindset, it shows you how valuable you are. You know, even when it doesn't work, I mean, it didn't work out for the Giants or for Eli a couple weeks ago against Philadelphia. He did not win that, lead the game-winning drive, but that's almost a sense of shock. And I think maybe we focus too much on what he is in the final minutes of a game. He's pretty good through the other parts of the game also. And certainly, I think you can talk about that MVP award because, you know, if you're going to take the valuable part of the trophy seriously, it's hard to imagine another player who's much more valuable than Eli, you know, in the entire league.
All right, and last question for you, Vac. Look, the Giants come into this game; they've won three in a row. They're 5-2. They during this stretch, as we talked about, a very impressive win in San Francisco over an excellent team in the 49ers. Give me the Giants' biggest issue right now, health aside, because obviously that's a variable we can't know. But what's the biggest issue that you're curious about still with this team right now?
I'm curious about them keeping their focus, which is pretty funny because you know the one thing that you've thought about them in the years they've won the Super Bowl is that they have a laser sharp focus, or they have the capacity for laser sharp focus. But we've also seen, you know, during long stretches of years, even last year, is that, you know, it's a team that, you know, for two, 3 weeks at a time can sometimes seem like it's a completely different team than when it's playing well. I do think that what the Giants would like to do if they want to make a real run at defending their title is you'd like to see them not only win the East, but maybe get a bye, certainly get a home playoff game. And there's only so many times you can tempt fate by going on the road. I know the Giants play really well on the road, but I think it really behooves them if they can. We still have a pretty dicey schedule ahead of them, but I mean, if they can start stringing wins together and you can get to 11 or 12, you know, you can talk about making your path in the playoffs a little bit less of a crazy option than it was the last couple of years. And look, I mean, the Giants are only going to be intimidated going on the road to play anybody in the regular season or in the postseason, but you probably wouldn't mind making that path a little bit easier because there's only so many times that they're going to be able to attempt fate like that.
All right, well, Giants will be on the road again this Sunday afternoon in Dallas, Cowboys Stadium. Giants will play the rematch against Tony Romo and company after losing to them in week one. Back will be there. You can read all his stuff on nypost.com. And, of course, you can follow him on Twitter at Mike Vack. That's with two C's. You can follow me at Hail Mark. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you soon.